Heart disease remains the number one cause of death in the United States, and the latest numbers from the American Heart Association are staggering. This year alone, it is predicted that 1 million people will either have a heart attack or die from heart disease, and nearly 800,000 will have a stroke. Now, though heart disease affects both men and women, women have a higher risk of having a stroke than men. And when it comes to heart attacks, symptoms differ between the sexes and are often misdiagnosed, leading to fewer women surviving their first heart attack. Here to tell us more about the warning signs and the steps that you can take in order to lower your risk is Dr. Carlos Alfonso, cardiologist with the University of Miami Health System. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, great to have you. Heart Health Month, go red for women. I got my red on. Can't get the message out more clearly that women really aren't, they're either not being told about heart health, they don't know what to look for, being misdiagnosed. Tell me what you tell your patients.
Yeah, I think that the important thing is to first awareness of the risk factors for heart disease in younger women. An ounce of prevention is better than a pound of cure down the road. So it's identifying patients that are at risk for heart disease. And as you mentioned, Heart Awareness Month, this month in February, is about getting the word out in terms of heart disease. The vital nature of being aware of your statistics, what's your blood pressure, cholesterol levels, smoking history, and family history are key and important in terms of identifying patients that may be at risk for heart disease.
Absolutely. Let's pop up some of what the high risk factors are so people have an idea if they're not too sure. High blood pressure is one of them, you just said. High cholesterol, obesity, being overweight, and then knowing your family history, that's really important, isn't it?
Absolutely. I think that that's for us, anybody that has an early family history of heart disease, that means paternal, a father that died before the age of 55 or a mother that died before the age of 65 of heart disease, that's a red flag that there may be a genetic a risk for heart disease.
So let's get back to women and why women aren't aware of their risk of having a heart attack or heart disease. We talked about it earlier, you and I think women are more aware of their reproductive health because we start going to the gynecologist from 18 on, most women, and we're not paying attention to what's going on with our ticker, if you will.
Absolutely.
So what is it that I guess it's incumbent upon us women, is it not, to ask those questions?
Yeah, I think early on it's asking the right questions, it's checking and it's being on top of it, and then recognizing the symptoms and the early symptoms of potential heart disease. So we feel that the hormones, the estrogens are protective for heart disease, but once women go through menopause, their risk of heart disease equals that of men.
Wow.
And that's not realized and that's not frequently talked about. So that's part of the goal, is to get the word out in terms of the risk for women.
And women don't necessarily know they're having a heart attack, do they? It's called like the silent heart attack. Walk us through some of those symptoms. What could be going on with us that we think is something else?
So frequently, like we talked about earlier, some of the symptoms get mischaracterized or misdiagnosed as asthma if they have shortness of breath, or anxiety if they're having chest pain or other symptoms. So I think it's recognizing the symptoms, chest pressure, particularly related to exercise, shortness of breath that's related to exercise or activity, are all warning signs that there may be onset of early coronary disease.
Like muscle ache even, right? You may have worked out and think you're just sore.
So sometimes they get mischaracterized,
yeah.
And particularly in women and the elderly, those symptoms get attributed to other causes, but it may be early signs of heart disease.
Wow. The other thing that I was shocked about is the high risk for Hispanic and African American women. Walk us through that.
Well, that has to do with various factors. It has to do with diet. It has to do with genetic risk factors. So I think that those are important to understand. And also it has to do with recognition. Many times women or men as well go many years without seeing a primary care doctor or checking their blood pressure or checking their cholesterol. So it's important to see the doctors, to ask them about blood pressure, cholesterol. Recently, the AHA and the national organizations have decreased the blood pressure, which is defined as high blood pressure. So whereas we used to look at blood pressure of 140 over 90 as high blood pressure, we've recently dropped that to 130 over 80, which means that there's a larger percentage of patients that are at risk, and at least not necessarily starting medications, but starting lifestyle modifications, exercising regularly 3 hours a week on average, cutting salt and fat and cholesterol on the diet are preventative things that we could do early on to delay the progression of heart disease. Smoking is another risk factor that we could eliminate completely and dramatically decrease our risk of having a heart attack in the future.
If I'm watching this and I don't necessarily have access to health care, maybe I don't have health insurance, but now I'm worried, what should I do?
Well, I think that's important. I think that one of the first things is to look at what are the lifestyle factors that you could look at. Smoking, we briefly mentioned, smoking cessation is one of the big easily modifiable risk factors. We can't change our genetics, but we can change what we do and what our lifestyle. Checking the blood pressure. It's easy enough to go into a local pharmacy or check what the blood pressure is.
Just one of those cups where you sit down and it squeezes your arm.
Yeah. Exactly. And then also cholesterol levels. So getting in touch with a primary care physician or even a minute clinic may be helpful to kind of get our baseline status of what we where you're at. And if there's any risk factors, I think it's important to have some further evaluation. And at the university, we're actually part of the Heart Awareness Month. We're offering some free health screenings and particularly in patients that have higher risk of heart disease, offering some more advanced screenings such as CT scans to look at calcium scoring to identify those at-risk patients and maybe prevent that first heart attack or prevent that first stroke before it happens.
Quickly, before we go, talk about aspirin. Should we carry aspirin around with us?
If there's a sufficient risk, yes. I mean, the aspirin is controversial. In the lower risk patients, it's probably not necessary. Mm-hmm. But in somebody who's identified to be at the higher risk categories, that's somebody that should probably be seen by at least a primary care physician, if not a cardiologist, to have further evaluation and then consider the options of aspirin.
Doctor, thank you so much. Great information. We really, really appreciate it.
Great. Thank you for having me.
And to learn more about keeping your heart healthy, visit the American Heart Association's website, heart.org. We'll also have more information for you on our Facebook page, @YourSouthFL.